Hey there, Amy Shepherd here today with Wednesday in the Works for Reverse Confetti. Summer 2017 may be winding down, but I couldn't resist squeezing in one more warm tropical summery card. The main event here is this colorful batik-inspired background. There are a lot of tutorials online with different ways to get a batik look on paper, so I definitely encourage you to check those out. I'll be using kind of your everyday supplies, dye ink, Versamark, stamps, and some white embossing powder. So nothing fancy there. I'm starting with a Premier Polar White cardstock panel. Premier Polar White is Reverse Confetti's new premium heavyweight white cardstock. I've prepped my panel with a powder tool to remove any static because I'm going to be doing some heat embossing on it. The stamp set that I'm using for the background is called Build a Bunch. Lots of beautiful florals and leaves to choose from in this one. I've really been enjoying this stamp set quite a bit. I've selected one large and one small image, and then I just randomly stamp in Versamark ink to cover the whole panel. This might be a little bit hard to see before I get the embossing powder on, so bear with me. I'm trying to leave some space in between the large flowers so that I have room for some smaller flowers in there too. Don't forget to rotate your image between impressions, and don't forget to stamp off the edges as well. Next, I dip the panel into my container of white embossing powder and hit it with a heat tool to melt the embossing powder. I don't know about you, I've heard this story over and over again, and I'm definitely in this camp. Heat embossing is what hooked me onto stamping so many years ago. It never gets old either, does it? Next comes the ink blending. I'm applying a very generous coverage of Flamingo, Rust, Magenta, and Peach, going back over each area to both add more color and to soften those transitions between the inks. The goal is to build up a very richly saturated background. By the time you're finished, not only do you have the original four colors, but lots of new colors where you've blended. I just love the warmth of all these colors together. Okay, now to help get the look of dyed fabric, I'm folding the paper to make creases or wrinkles. You can do as much or as little of this as you like, depending on how crumpled you want the piece to look. Next, I'm going back over the panel with more ink to help bring out those creases. Next, I wanted to add some fabric texture. For this, I'm just very lightly swiping my magenta ink pad over the whole background, swiping both from top to bottom and side to side. That kind of gives it the look of grain, of a fabric grain or a weave that you would see in real fabric. Be sure to let that dry a few seconds and then use a clean towel to wipe the excess ink off. It pulls up a little bit on those embossed areas because that embossing is resisting the ink, so you want to wipe that off for sure. To finish the card, I first trimmed down the batik panel and then I roughed up the edges using a distressing tool. Remember those? Here, you're going to see me go back in and add even more ink blending. I wanted some areas to be super saturated, just like you sometimes see in batik fabrics where the dye has kind of, pulled up. It really gives it that hand-dyed look. So I'm finally ready to put this on a card base. I decided to do a split panel design. So first I trimmed off 1 inch for the bottom panel, and then I trimmed off and discarded about 1/4 inch in between. And then I went back and distressed those newly cut edges so that, they would match. The Happy Birthday Sentiment from Sentiment Essentials will sit right over that split. I thought it needed something behind it, so I just added a very simple white stitched circle die cut. This one is from the Pop-Up Circle Confetti Cuts set. I also added one tiny flower accent, also from the Build-A-Bunch stamp set. This time ink blended in Rust. I popped those batik layers up with some fun foam, and then I added my sentiment, and that completes the card. Thanks so much for joining me today. Hope you've enjoyed this. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Join us each month on our blog for our Sketch for You to Try challenge. That's your chance to win a Reverse Confetti gift certificate. Go to www.reverseconfetti.com and look for the blue Play to Win button. Also, September 5th begins the countdown for our September release. So tune in to the Reverse Confetti blog September 5th, 6th, 7th. The release is on the 8th, and we do a blog hop on the 8th as well. So hope to see you then. Bye-bye.